Hey guys, Patrick Smith from Vision Miner, and today we're doing an unboxing of the Funmat HT. We're gonna be opening this up, see all the accessories that come with it from the factory, get it on the table, and go through the steps to get to our first successful print. So we're gonna go ahead and get started right now. I'm gonna have my buddies Rob and Josh come in to help me. The machine's a little bit heavy, so we'll have them help. We'll get this out and get it onto the table. Come on in, guys. Get that. You notice the lid comes off. You have the quick start guide right here. We'll set that to the side. You'll notice the sides just slide right off. Then we got the foam, top layer. Nice, that looks good. All right, if you guys can get that up on the table, I'll hold the foam. There we go. Awesome. Nice, guys. So there you have it, Funmat HT. This thing is beautiful, guys. As you notice, it's a little bit heavy, and I actually like that because it makes it more robust, more industrial feeling. You'll see some smaller machines made of plastic and stuff that move around. They don't really have a bunch of weight to it. So I do like the engineering and the design on this. So let's go ahead and we'll dive into the next step, which is unpacking all this stuff. What I like to do is take the doors off. It's a really cool feature, super easy. And you got some latches right in here. Just pull this down, that pops out, and I'll set this to the side, and then I'll go ahead and take the top one off, exact same way, allows us to work around the machine much easier. So the first thing we want to do is go ahead and take out, these are the accessories, so we're going to take out this first lever here, first layer, you notice press down a little bit to clear this nut right there. Just slide it out, and bam, we got that. Awesome, set that right there. And then the second one, perfect, we got that. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna manually turn the ball screw on the Z axis so that we can lower this bed. The styrofoam goes up and wraps around the extruder itself. I also mentioned the X and Y axis are locked in place with some screws and some clamps to keep it from moving during shipment. So I'm gonna start turning this to get it lowered down. There we go. And then you can grab the back of it. And then as you're turning, you can help pull it down. And there. Okay, now we should be able to take this off. Perfect, clears the nozzle. And that comes right out. We'll set that to the side too. So let's move on to the packages and accessories and see what we have included in there. So I'll bring this one over. First thing we got, USB card reader, power cable, got the USB wire. This will plug into the side right here for when we need to do firmware updates. Got the 7mm wrench. That's going to be used to get these screws up here to take those locks off of the X and Y axis. And it also fits the nozzles so we can do quick nozzle changes. Comes with the SD card. You'll be able to use that to put your files on and then slide the SD card right in here when you're ready to print. A nice pair of gloves. These are heat resistant gloves. They'll come in very handy, especially working around peak and the temperatures of the build plates and such. So that's a nice added gift. We have in here a leveling card, which you can lay this card right here on the bed or the print glass, and when you're doing your bed leveling, you can use that. But don't use this when doing peak because the temperature, 160 degree print bed, will melt this. So this is just for PLA. So set that to the side. And then the last thing we have in here is two pieces of frosted glass. That's for your print bed. This is a really nice feature because they give us two of them, which will come in handy if we accidentally break one. It's happened in the past with me. Last thing you wanna do is be waiting days for the new print glass to arrive. So it's really cool that they send two. So awesome, that completes that. Let's go ahead and see what we have in this one here. Nice, guys. This is the instructions for the Wi-Fi cam. We have two nozzles, two hot ends. We already have the cold end that comes with it, so it comes with another hot end, and it comes with a spare hot end. Comes with a pair of flush cutters. Those come in real handy for cutting the filament and stuff like that. Spatula for popping prints off the print glass. Couple zip ties. And then we have the wrench. pair of tweezers, nice little feature. Those come in handy for grabbing little things. Two extra gears, three nozzles, the correct Allen wrenches that we need, and then here is the extruder. So there you have it, guys. That's all the accessories that come with it. We're gonna go ahead and move into the next part, which is prepping the extruder and getting the machine ready for its first print. You may have seen the footage over there when we first did it, those clamps that are on the X and Y axis. And this is what holds the extruder in place to keep it moving around during shipment. So we're just gonna go in there. We got the 7mm nut driver that it came with and the 3mm Allen screw. So I already took three of them off. I left one to show you guys exactly how to do it. We're gonna go in there and you'll see, got the nut. I'm just gonna hold the bottom with my finger right there and start undoing this. That nut came right off. Take the washer off, let the screw fall out. Bam, got those. Set those to the side. I'll keep these in the package just in case I ever have to send this in for service or maintenance. And then I like to take these needle nose and I'm just going to spread that apart to get it off of the bar. So now we got this off, guys, all four of them, and we can move on to the next part, which is putting the extruder in place. There's two screws currently in there, so we're gonna remove those two screws with the 3mm hex wrench. Right here. Get these loosened up. There we go, do it with our fingers. Get these out. And then let's get the other one. Got that one. Okay, so now let's take the extruder here, guys. This is gonna be the plug with all the power and cables that plugs in there. It's a really nice one plug system, so we can quickly, easily remove this. We're gonna take those two screws and it's gonna go right through here. So you'll notice that there's also a hole on the bottom here, guys. I don't know if you can see that on camera. This is where the feed tube right there is gonna go right into that hole. That went in very easily. I'm gonna run this wire straight through here and then plug it in right there. So that's good. And be careful, I like to keep one hand on this until I get those first two screws we removed, and we're just gonna get those right back in. Get one started, take this one, started, and now I can tighten these up with the Allen wrench. I like to get them down where they're a little bit snug, and they kind of go crisscross like you're tightening a tire, and then once they're good, we can give it the final tightening. Be careful not to, I mean, it's going in to steel, but just be careful that you don't strip the threads. You want it tight enough, but don't crank down on it. Okay, and that's it. Last thing we can do, I'm gonna take some of those zip ties that came with it, and I'm gonna secure these three cables together right here. Keep those cables nice and snug. I'm gonna take the flush cutters that came with it to cut off the excess of the zip tie. Bingo. And then lastly, don't forget this piece right here, your tube, and that just slides right in. All right, so guys, as you see, really easy, quick couple steps to get this up and ready. Now I'm gonna go ahead, plug it in, turn the power switch on, it'll boot up, put the plate glass on there, and then we'll home the axis and we'll be ready to start printing. Grab my plug right here, power switch, nice. You see that's booting up already. Grab the frosted glass, slide that in. Make sure it's nice and tight. It's up against this rail here. And latch it down. Awesome. Now we'll come up here. This is the home screen. So we're gonna tap on Axie. And then we're gonna go to home. Are you sure you want to home all axes? Yes. Z axis coming up. It's gonna hit the limit switch. Home it. Perfect. Nice. Awesome, guys. So there you have it. As you see, it's not hard at all to get straight out of the box, onto the desk and ready for the first print. Guys, I hope this makes it easy, gives you a little bit of an idea what comes with the Funmat HT, how easy it is to set up. Now we can move on to the first successful print. We got those videos up for you guys, so check them out. It's how to level the build plate, how to load the filament, and how to do your first successful print in PEEK. So we hope these videos helps, guys. If it does, please hit that subscribe button. We love your support. Thank you so much. Hope it helps. Get your printers, start making money, get your business up and going. Have an outstanding day, and I'll see you on the next video.